إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. These days are the best days, and we are in the day of Arafah. And in this year, Arafah day comes in Jum'ah day. And both of them are Eid. Both of them are blessed days. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all days, and He gave specific virtues for these days. The first 10 days of the Hijjah, Jum'ah day, Arafah day, Eid day, the first day of Ayyam Tashriq, and all of the Ayyam Tashriq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear, by the dawn. Then He said, وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ, and by 10 nights. And it is what is common among most of the scholars, it means the first 10 nights and also days of Dhul Hijjah. وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. الشَّفْع, some scholars said, it means the Eid day, the 10th day. وَالْوَتْرِ means Arafah day. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by something, it means the significance and the importance of these things. And as you know, the common hadith, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, مَا الْعَمَلْ فِي أَيَّامْ أَفْضَلْ مِنْهَا فِي هَذِهِ, قَالْ وَلَا الْجِهَادِ, قَالْ وَلَا الْجِهَادِ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ خَرَجَ يُخَاطِرُ بِنَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ فَلَمْ يَرْجِعْ بِشَيْءٍ. The common hadith, as you know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, no good deeds done on other days are superior to those done on this, which means the first 10 days of the Hijjah. Then some companions asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, even the jihad, doing the righteous deeds during the 10 days of the Hijjah, the first 10 days of the Hijjah, even they are better than the jihad? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam replied, not even jihad, except that a man who does it by putting himself and his property in danger and doesn't retain with any of those things. Can you imagine? Siyam, Salah, charity, dua, dhikr, within 10 days will be better than generally the jihad. O Muslims, we are in the day of Arafah, the day of forgiveness, the day of dua, the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. There are two incidents regarding this ayah. One of them with Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما, and one of them with Umar al-Khattab رضي الله تعالى عنه. The narration of Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما recited this ayah, today I have perfected for you your religion. The ayah. This ayah, a Jew said to Ibn Abbas, if this verse had been revealed to us, we would have made it a Eid, a festival. Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma said, it was revealed on a day which contained two Eid. He is coming to teach Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. Abdullah Ibn Abbas said, it was not only one Eid, there were two Eid. Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma said, he means on a Friday and on the day of Arafah. Eid, it is not only one Eid, two Eid, Arafah and Jum'ah, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was in Arafah on the day of Jum'ah. It was Jum'ah. So Jum'ah is our weekly Eid, and also Arafah is one of the Eid for Muslims. And also another hadith, something the same with Umar al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. A Jew said to Umar al-Khattab, O Amir al-Mu'mineen, O the chief of believers, they know who is Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. Radiyallahu ta'ala an. This day I have perfected, he means this ayah, this day I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favors upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. The Jew said, had been revealed upon us, we would have taken that day as an Eid. Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an said, I know definitely on what day this verse was revealed. It was revealed on the day of Arafah, on a Friday. So again, the same thing. Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an knows. This Jew wants to teach Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an. It was Eid of Arafah and also Eid of Jum'ah. Two Eid. So the same thing said by Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an and also Abdullah ibn Abbas. This day is no doubt a special day for people who are doing Hajj. May Allah protect them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, there is no day on which Allah the Mighty subhanahu wa ta'ala and sublime frees more of his slaves, male and female, or from the fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees his slaves from the hellfire in Ramadan every night, and also other days, other times, but specifically for the day of Arafah, more people. He said sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he comes close subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way we don't know. He knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he puts the angels about them and say, he prays the believers in front of the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, what do these people want? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come close in a way that he knows subhanahu wa ta'ala, ila sama' ad-dunya, to the first heaven, saying to his angels, what these people need and what these people want, the people of Arafah, who are now maybe 2 or 3 million in Arafah. Why they are going there? Asking the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a great hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the Fajr after Arafah. The Fajr, which means Eid day. After the day of Arafah. He said to Bilal, O Bilal, askit li an-nas, tell people to be quiet. Which means I'm going to tell them something very important. Listen, tell people to listen. Then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah has been very gracious to you in this jam', in this jam' of yours. He has forgiven the wrongdoers among you because of the righteous among you. And he has given the righteous among you whatever they ask. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam moved on in the name of Allah. Move on, which means he was in Muzdalifah, move on to Mina. Alayhi salatu wassalam. In that day, no doubt, some people are wrongdoers. They have major sins. And other people, righteous people, who have less sins, only minor sins. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave the sinners because of the righteous people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the righteous people what they ask. The day of Arafah. Ibn Rajab, one of the great scholars, said about the day of Arafah. Day of Arafah is the day of freeing from the hellfire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free the people of Mawqif, those who are in Arafah. And also the other people who are not in Arafah. This is a great favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this day is for the people in Arafah or in Arafat, and also people who are in the day of Arafah, other places than Arafat. Arafah is the day of dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, The best dua, أفضل الدعاء. Dua يوم عرفة, which means this is a general hadith. The best dua is the dua of the day of Arafah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the most excellent dua is the dua of the day of Arafah. And the best what of what I and the prophets before me have said, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. أقول ما تسمعون الحمد لله. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد أما بعد. One of the virtues of this day, our day, today, Arafah day, the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, this one of the Eid days, to fast this day. Fasting this day, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned, fasting on the day of Arafah is an expiation for the preceding year and the following year. 1 year before this day and 1 year after this day will be forgiven for you. Because of what? Because of fasting 14 or 13 hours. Alhamdulillah, it is a Friday and it is off, very easy for the Muslim, even if it is working day, very easy for many Muslims to fast the day of Arafah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also mentioned, in a'adham al-ayyam inda Allahi tabaraka wa ta'ala yawm al-nahr wa yawm al-qarr. This hadith about tomorrow, the 10th day. Brothers, we are living in the best days. Today is Arafah and also tomorrow is the Eid day. Yawm al-Nahr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the greatest day, the greatest day in Allah's sight subhanahu wa ta'ala is the day of sacrifice. Yawm al-Nahr. When we do our udhiyah. And next, the day of resting, which is the next day of Eid, the 11th day of Dhul Hijjah. This is the best day, tomorrow, Yawm al-Nahr, or Yawm al-Eid. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith, the day of Arafah, the day of sacrifice, and the days of al-Tashriq, the 3 days after Eid. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are our Eid, people of Islam. Eiduna Ahl Islam. These days our Eid. Celebrate these days. Let people feel the joy, your family, in these days. The sunnah to celebrate these days. These days. The days of Eid. Not the other days, the days of the non-Muslims. We should be proud of our religion. And celebrating these days, sunnah, you will get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at the end, brothers, sisters, remember the Hajjaj, the pilgrims there. And remember them in your dua. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect them. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the Hajj from them and to give them the chance to return back to their countries with peace, secure, and the ajr, the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma aghfir al-mu'minina wal-mu'minat wal-muslimina wal-muslimat الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. اجعلنا اللهم من الراشدين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم ارحم موتانا، اللهم احفظ الشباب والبنات يا رب العالمين، اللهم وفق ولاة امورنا لما تحب وترضى، اللهم وحد الامه الاسلاميه على الخير والتوحيد والسنه يا رب العالمين. واخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.